The deals are hot now at Greenville Toyota. Get a 2020 Corolla now under 17 grand. Plus, get no charge lifetime maintenance included with every purchase. That's the Greenville Advantage. Greenville Toyota, where our volume saves you money.
I'm sexy and I know it.
Top Dog Academy is Eastern North Carolina's complete dog training facility. Top Dog provides an excellent environment for dogs of all ages with training services and work week daycare. Top Dog is located on Highway 43 South, just 4 miles from Bells Fork, and features a comfortable, healthy environment and a spacious facility for daycare and a brand new, beautiful facility for training. Call 752-8215 or visit topdogonline.com.
Come on out Highway 43 South to Top Dog Academy, where we know dogs.
My name is Dr. Neeti Armistead, Chief Medical Officer for Vidant Health. The following simple steps will help keep you and your community safe. Stay home as much as possible, wear a mask when out in public, avoid large gatherings, practice social distancing, and wash hands often. It's also important not to delay needed care. Vidant has taken important steps to provide you and your family with a safe environment. Learn more about COVID-19 and Vidant's response. Call 252-847-8000 or visit vidanthealth.com/COVID-19.
Mom, I'm so bored.
The most music for your workday with Mark, and Laura, Beth McCall, and Dylan McKay.
The most music for your workday plays here.
The trade-in deals are hot at Greenville Toyota. Hot, hot, hot. We're cutting checks on the spot for trades and giving you up to 130% of book value. That means if it's worth 10 grand, we'll give you 13. Rush to Greenville Toyota. This is Talk of the Town with Henry Hinton on Talk 96.3 and 103.7.
Hey, welcome in, everybody. Talk of the Town at 8 minutes after 8 o'clock. Welcome to Hour 2, just at the coffee pot, talking to all the troubleshooters in the building. We got everybody that works here in the building right now working on all these problems. We think we got hacked or something overnight last night. Something happened, and every radio station we have has got some issues of some sort. And now my internet just went out. Did you?
No, I'm still.
How are
still
you, McGee?
Up. I'm doing well.
Nice
I'm
to
doing
see
well.
You.
Yeah,
we're going to get through it. We've got
we
got a great guest this hour. Live in the studio, the GOP nominee for Secretary of State, E.C. Sykes, is going to be live in the studio this morning. So we are happy to have E.C. back in town, and we'll be talking to him in just a couple of minutes. I know that Chief Justice of the Supreme Court, Paul Newby, is also in Greenville today. And we talked last hour about the poll that ECU just released that shows Mark Robinson doing really well compared to everybody else. Although if you missed that information, the new ECU poll has Trump tied with Biden in North Carolina. And he's been down in North Carolina in that poll, I think, by as many as 4 points. Didn't you see that somewhere?
I did. Mm-hmm.
And pre-convention, Trump was down to Biden in North Carolina 49-47. So Mark Robinson is up in his race 43-40 over the Democrat candidate for lieutenant governor, which no one knows who it is. So even the Democrats are just voting for the Democrat or saying they're going to vote for the Democrat there. I still don't know her name either. Let's see, what is her name? But the governor's race still has a 10-point deficit for Dan Forrest. But Dan is closing. Right before the convention, that number was 14 points. And so Forrest going in the right direction and Cooper going in the wrong direction. So we'll see if that trend continues now that we're heading to Labor Day. And, of course, people really start to pay attention post-Labor Day.
Yeah, I think it's starting to happen. You're starting to see more people talk about the elections, both nationwide and statewide. Hearing conversations, people are curious now about local races, state races. So I think it's really going to heat up and get going, I think, early next week and then until November 3rd. So it's going to be a wild next couple of months.
The Democrat candidate for lieutenant governor, by the way, is Yvonne Lewis Holley.
Yeah, I knew that.
Who was that?
I knew that.
I think she's a state senator or something.
I think you're correct about that.
I don't know. But Mark Robinson is going to be in Greenville, and, of course, he has just become such a huge draw. We had him down on the deck down at Southern Salt a few weeks ago, and he drew a huge crowd down there. And so it's interesting that Mark Robinson, this is the first poll we've seen in the lieutenant governor's race, really doing better than anybody else. And I think it's interesting. He's getting 13% of the black vote. This is going to be interesting to see if he pulls black voters to the Republican Party. I've been saying that if anybody can, he will. And Trump was only getting 8% of the black vote prior to the convention. Now he's getting almost 13%, 12.6% of the black vote. And again, as Peter Franzia always warns, when you get down to those numbers, sometimes the margin of error number can be a little funky. So and those numbers might not be totally accurate, but I do believe that the polling numbers overall are accurate because they're all within the margin of error. And right now, Trump and Biden tied at 49. And I'm sorry, not tied. Trump leading Biden 49-47. Yeah, Tillis two, and yeah. Cunningham are tied. And that's by the way, that's a big jump for Tom Tillis as well. Mm-hmm. That's a 4-point jump for Tom Tillis. He is now tied with Cunningham, and we saw that as a 44-40 lead for Cunningham just less than a month ago before the convention. And again, the number in the governor's race now is Cooper 50 and Forrest 40. Dan Forrest is going to join us when we're in Edenton in 2 weeks. We're going to be up there September 17th. And so we're excited about being in Edenton coming up, and Dan Forrest will join us. I'll tell you more about that later this morning. But also want to mention that next week, a week from today, on September the 9th, we're going to have our Talk of the Town tour stop in Swansboro. We're going to be at the Boro Restaurant, thanks to our buddy Randy Swanson down there, who's actually going to be serving breakfast. And I'll tell you about the breakfast in a second, but let me mention our sponsors in Swansboro next week. Swansboro Music and Pawn, S&H Feed and Garden, Hearst Realty, Flatwoods Outfitters, John Stanley, the Farm Bureau agent there in Swansboro, the two Swansboro locations of Edward Jones and Associates, Carteret Heating and Cooling, the Dairy Queen in Swansboro, which is owned, by the way, by the mayor, John Davis, Advanced Office, and, of course, the Borough. So here's the deal. Next Wednesday morning, we will be live at the Borough in Swansboro, and we want everybody to come out. There is going to be breakfast served, and here is the deal, McGee. Won't let me open that file. Wonder why. See if I can open it on my phone. They're going to be doing – oh, here it is. So they're going to be doing a special breakfast – at the Borough next Wednesday morning from 7 to 10 while we're there broadcasting. We'll be on the air 7 to 9. And all of the proceeds is going to go to Randy's charity, his favorite charity, Hope is Alive. So the money will go to charity, $15. Randy's going to give it all. They're going to have cook-to-order omelets. They're going to have biscuits, sausage gravy, cheese grits, home fries, sausage bacon, country ham, scrambled eggs, eggs Benedict, pancakes. A huge breakfast event coming up in Swansboro next Wednesday morning, and it's all the proceeds are going to go to the charity, which we mentioned a minute ago, Hope is Alive, and that's going to be at the Boro Restaurant next Wednesday morning, and that is where we will be live on Talk of the Town. So please come out and join us. All right, let's see what else is going on. We mentioned the poll. I did not have an opportunity to talk about much else last hour.
We didn't get into our power report. ECU's back at football practice on Tuesday.
We saw that Holton Ahlers was out on the field.
Yes, he was.
And did you hear that Coach Houston said that he had a stomach bug? And there was a question about why he didn't participate in the rally down on the university campus on
Monday.
And then Holton did a video saying he wished that he could have been there, which led to a lot of speculation. But he was back on the practice field yesterday, and Coach Houston said in his press conference yesterday after practice that Holton just had a stomach bug. So that's good news.
Yeah.
But the numbers.
But 23 players are still out.
23 people. We didn't
people,
say players.
Excuse me, people.
Some of them are staff. Some of them are, maybe trainers and student trainers and stuff. But the numbers, again, that doesn't mean that 23 of them have COVID. Because if you have been in close contact, remember what John Gilbert told us, if you've been in close contact,
right,
you have to quarantine with them. So they had 23 people still quarantined as of yesterday. Mm-hmm. Maybe some of them will get to come back. But the good news is they're practicing. First game is on for UCF. No talk yesterday that I heard. Did you hear any talk about them scheduling a game on the 19th?
I did not. No, not yesterday. Mm-mm. No.
So, yeah. That's... that's still to be determined, I guess. But I think if they're going to do it, they're going to have to announce it pretty soon.
Yeah. This week, maybe.
I had heard now through the grapevine at the athletic department that Coach Houston really wants to play a game on the 19th because obviously you don't want your first game to be the best team in the conference.
Right.
Central Florida. And the chances of the September 19th game happening are, somewhat slim. But it's not out of the question. So we'll see. I mentioned that movie theaters are really the big loser along with bars in the new governor's order. And I got these numbers from last night from a gym owner. Apparently, the executive director of the Respiratory Care Board in North Carolina, Dr. Croft, is setting up a survey site. And they're going to try to get their arms around how many people have been actually infected from COVID because they've gone to the gym. The numbers that I got last night, and again, these numbers were sent to me by a gym owner, 405,000 front desk check-ins at gyms since June 1st in the state of North Carolina, not one positive case of COVID-19. So these incredible restrictions, North Carolina now the only state in the union, the only state in the United States of America that still has movie theaters closed. But, hey, we can go to the playground now. And I did get a confirmation. Somebody said that trampoline parks were mentioned, so maybe ARU is not going to have
hope
a problem.
Hope so. I didn't hear that. Hope so.
Maybe TJ and his wife won't get threatened with arrest again. It still blows me away that we've got a business owner here that was literally threatened to be put in handcuffs and taken to jail. $6 million investment for a new family fun park here in Greenville. And I was out there last night, and it's spectacular. And they're opening on Friday.
I can't wait to see it.
So it'll be a great Labor Day weekend for your kids, something to do. And everybody was wearing masks. It was it's a great environment. And by the way, the restaurant and the bar are fantastic. This is something that we haven't seen in Greenville before.
Never.
We talked yesterday about some of the stuff we've lost in Greenville since March. Some of the businesses and restaurants that we've lost. Well, here's here's a brand new business and opportunity for families to have a new place to have the kids to go and know that they'll be safe. And it's spectacular. The kids were running around. They did the laser tag last night. They were doing the arcade and the rock walls and the trampolines. It's really something.
Man, you know, families are so excited about this. And, yeah, I know they're thanking T.J. Sawyer for starting this, getting this going, because there's nothing else like it anywhere in the East, anywhere around. So I can't wait to take my kids.
All right, let's get a break in, and we will come back again. We've caught up finally after some technical issues this morning after the Russian hackers took out all our computers. I want to thank Dylan McKay and Dan is here as well this morning, and also I would like to also thank you, Michael. You did a lot of hard work this morning in trying to get us back on the air. So Dan Miller, Dylan McKay, Michael got everything working because when we got in here this morning, Michael, when you got here, what, like 6 o'clock? Everything was
five.
You got in at five?
Yeah, gone.
Everything was askew.
Yeah.
And so we've gotten I think all the squirrels have been fed now. We got all the wheels turning and we're back to normal. 21 after 8. We'll be right back.
The deals are hot now at Greenville Toyota. Hot, hot, hot. Get a 2020 Corolla now under 17 grand. Plus, get no charge lifetime maintenance included with every purchase. That's the Greenville Advantage. Greenville Toyota, where our volume saves you money.
I'm sexy and I know it.
Top Dog Academy is Eastern North Carolina's complete dog training facility. Top Dog provides an excellent environment for dogs of all ages with training services and workweek daycare. Top Dog is located on Highway 43 South, just 4 miles from Bellsfort, and features a comfortable, healthy environment and a spacious facility for daycare and a brand new, beautiful facility for training. Call 752-8215 or visit topdogonline.com.
Come on out Highway 43 South to Top Dog Academy, where we know dogs.
My name is Dr. Neeti Armistead, Chief Medical Officer for Vidant Health. The following simple steps will help keep you and your community safe. Stay home as much as possible, wear a mask when out in public, avoid large gatherings, practice social distancing, and wash hands often. It's also important not to delay needed care. Vidant has taken important steps to provide you and your family with a safe environment. Learn more about COVID-19 and Vidant's response. Call 252-847-8000 or visit vidanthealth.com/COVID-19.
Mom, I'm so bored.
The most music for your workday with Mark, and Laura, Beth McCall, and Dylan McKay.
The most music for your workday plays here.
Trade-in deals are hot at Greenville Toyota. Hot, hot, hot. We're cutting checks on the spot for trades and giving you up to 130% of book value. That means if it's worth 10 grand, we'll give you 13. Rush to Greenville Toyota. Your week.
Police officers, I'm praying for you.
Your news every day as events happen.
God bless and plasma for patients.
We'll happen to be there.
We can't have Joe Biden rule the country and have no police.
Joe Biden's agenda is made in China.
Back to the show that really makes you think.
Come on, man.
Talk 96.3 and 103.7. This is Talk of the Town with Henry Hinton.
Okay, welcome back. 24 after 8 o'clock. Again, we got a great guest coming up in just a few minutes. The GOP nominee for Secretary of State, E.C. Sykes, is in the house. And we will be talking to E.C. in a minute. We are now almost an hour and a half into the program. Again, you haven't mentioned any. Have you noticed anything?
I have.
Different?
Yeah, you have some brand new glasses.
I do.
And I was thinking to myself, you look a little bit younger.
Oh, wow.
Don't you think so, Michael? A little bit? A little teeny bit?
You're asking Michael to say something nice about me.
Hell, I thought he had new shoes, so what do I know?
No.
Michael's a comedian, isn't he?
I noticed him when you walked in, and I think it helps with the shirt you have on, too. They kind of stand out.
Yeah.
But I was going to wait and mix him at the right time.
I went to see Dr. McIntosh over at Carolina Vision Care and had my annual eye exam. And I told him, I feel like I need something new. He picked out my last frames because he wanted me to promote those slate frames. But I called her in out of the bullpen, and she picked these frames out. She said, you need something lighter because your hair's getting lighter.
Yeah. There's not a contrast there. That kind of goes together well.
So Carolina,
she made a good selection.
Carolina Vision Care, which, of course, is one of our great sponsors on the program and has been forever. Well, Doctors McIntosh, Dr. Tom, who is the patriarch of the family, and Dr. Scott McIntosh now, and Dr. Natalie McIntosh, all at Carolina Vision Care. And they have a new office open, and the office is open on Fire Tower Road now.
It's also more of a sporty look. I think you can do more with those.
That's the great thing about Carolina Vision Care. You get great eye care, but you also can get your glasses and frames and a great choice of frames. In fact, there are so many frames I had a hard time picking. My wife really had a hard time picking the ones that she liked. But if it makes me look younger, then that probably is why she liked these. Mm-hmm. She wants a younger man. All right, 26 after. Carolina Vision Care, again, if you need an eye doctor, I love these guys, the McIntosh family, great family. They become friends. When you go and get your eyes examined, you'll find out what I'm talking about. Everybody there is so friendly, and the McIntoshes have become great friends of mine. I didn't know them before I started going to Dr. Tom, but he's become a great friend, as has the entire family, a family business, a family practice. And again, now a second location on Fire Tower Road if you need eye care. Their number, by the way, is 252-752-4380. 752-4380. All right, let's get some news headlines in. I'm trying to get things back to normal here. Here's McGee at the news desk.
All right, the Johnston County Sheriff's Office is continuing its search this morning for a 5-year-old girl and her 4-year-old brother who were swept away by high flood waters in Johnston County Monday night. Their mother was driving their car when she called 911 around 11:30 Monday night after her white sedan was swept into a creek off Galilee Road, which connects to the Neuse River near West Smithfield Elementary School. While officials remain hopeful, they said the mission will switch from a search and rescue to a recovery effort at some point. Starting this Friday, Governor Roy Cooper's Phase 2.5 plan for reopening will take effect under 2.5 Safer at Home Order. More businesses such as gyms, fitness centers, museums, bowling alleys, and aquariums will be allowed to reopen with certain limitations. Bars, nightclubs, and movie theaters, however, must still remain closed. Members of the North Carolina General Assembly will return to Raleigh today to begin a limited session in the midst of the COVID-19 pandemic. House and Senate Republicans have already devised an economic relief package that calls for spending an estimated $1 billion in leftover CARES Act funding to assist parents with child care and education needs. The measure must still be signed by Governor Roy Cooper. The suspect in a weekend robbery in Greenville that was captured on a doorbell camera has been identified and arrested. 24-year-old Taquan Hardison, of Greenville, has been charged with one count of common law robbery. The victim was walking into his apartment when he was rushed from behind by the suspect. The suspect assaulted the victim and stole his wallet and cash. Hardison was booked into the Pitt County Detention Center under a $50,000 bond. Congressman Greg Murphy and G.K. Butterfield urged the U.S. House leadership to quickly extend the PSP to ensure American Airlines continue service out of Greenville. Murphy and Butterfield sent a joint letter to Speaker Nancy Pelosi and Minority Leader Kevin McCarthy requesting they include a clean extension of the payroll support program in any future COVID-19 relief legislation. American announced in July that it will permanently suspend service at 15 regional airports, including PGV, when the payroll support protection expires on September 30th. And in national news, President Donald Trump is calling violent protests in major cities domestic terror. Speaking at a law enforcement roundtable in Kenosha, Wisconsin on Tuesday, Trump said he strongly supports the use of the National Guard to help put an end to the violence. Trump said it would be all be over quickly if local governments would allow federal agents to come in. Henry?
Can you imagine these mayors not asking for National Guard
Absolutely
help?
Absolutely not, no.
I mean, what are they thinking? I mean, if you don't think it's political, again, they don't want to give Trump any credit for stopping the violence, but they can't do it on their own, obviously.
No, I don't understand it.
It's just crazy what's happening. Let's check our weather update. As we head toward Labor Day weekend, clouds giving way to sun today. It's going to be hot. Temperatures are going to be up around 92 degrees, only a 20% chance of a late afternoon thunderstorm. And then on Thursday, a few clouds. High temperatures will be in the mid-90s. Tomorrow's going to be very hot, in fact, 95 for a high, but no chance of rain. Pretty much the same forecast for Friday. And, of course, we'll be checking our boating forecast tomorrow and Friday, see what it's like for the Labor Day weekend. But looking ahead to the weekend, Saturday looks very nice, 86 with some cloud cover, 20% chance of rain. And on Sunday, 84, no chance of rain. Monday, everybody's got Monday off, I think, 86 and no chance of rain. So looks like a pretty good weekend for Labor Day weekend. News and weather service this hour of the Tire Realty Group. Tire Realty Group, of course, we keep talking about how they're selling one home a day, and they're the hot real estate group here in Greenville. But here's the other thing. A lot of folks out of work right now, if you've been thinking about making a career change because of the uncertainty in your current job, and if this sounds like, you know, it might be time for a change, you should call Homer or Rachel Tire at Tire Realty. Here's why. You don't even have to have a license. If you or someone you know has ever even thought about a career in real estate, now is the time because the real estate market is hot. There's good money to be made. And, of course, why not go work for the guys that do more marketing than anybody in the entire region, Tire Realty Group. Whether you're licensed or not, Rachel and Homer say give them a call. I'll give you the number in just a second. The housing market is on fire, so don't let this pass you by. Those of you who've been out of work, looking for something, this is it. Get into the real estate market, and they'll help you get your license and get you moving, making some good, good income off of the hot real estate market here in the Greenville market. Tire Realty Group at 252-758-HOME. That's 758-4663, or you can visit them online at tirerealtygroup.com. And if you've listed your home with them, one more thing, don't list it till you're ready to move because you need to start packing when you list it because they're going to sell it fast. 832, 28 in front of 9. Quick break. We're coming back, and we're going to meet one of the candidates for statewide office. E.C. Sykes, running for Secretary of State, is here live in the studio. We'll be right back.
The trade-in deals are hot at Greenville Toyota. We're cutting checks on the spot for trades and giving you up to 130% of book value. That means if it's worth 10 grand, we'll give you 13. Rush to Greenville Toyota.
Top Dog Academy is Eastern North Carolina's complete dog training facility. Top Dog provides an excellent environment for dogs of all ages with training services and workweek daycare. Top Dog is located on Highway 43 South, just 4 miles from Bellsfort, and features a comfortable, healthy environment and a spacious facility for daycare and a brand new, beautiful facility for training. Call 752-8215 or visit topdogonline.com.
Come on out Highway 43 South to Top Dog Academy, where we know dogs.
best music for your workday with Mark, Mark, and Laura, Beth McCall, and Dylan McKay.
The most music for your workday plays here.
My name is Dr. Neeti Armistead, Chief Medical Officer for Vidant Health. The following simple steps will help keep you and your community safe. Stay home as much as possible, wear a mask when out in public, avoid large gatherings, practice social distancing, and wash hands often. It's also important not to delay needed care. Vidant has taken important steps to provide you and your family with a safe environment. Learn more about COVID-19 and Vidant's response. Call 252-847-8000 or visit vidanthealth.com/COVID-19.
I'm sexy and I know it.
The deals are hot now at Greenville Toyota. Get a 2020 Corolla now under 17 grand. Plus, get no charge lifetime maintenance included with every purchase. That's the Greenville Advantage. Greenville Toyota, where our volume saves you money.
It must be time to get back to Talk of the Town with Henry Hinton.
He's kind of a diva.
He's absolutely fascinating.
Ultimate gentleman spy. Irresistible to women, deadly to his enemies, a legend in his own time.
You won't believe what he's going to say next on Talk 96.3 and 103.7.
Okay, 836, 24 in front of 9 o'clock, and in the studio live with me this morning, the Republican nominee for statewide office, the Secretary of State office, E.C. Sykes, has joined us live, and I've gotten to know E.C. over the last 4 or 5 months, and been very impressed with him, and now he's back in Greenville today doing some campaigning, and decided to stop and say hello to us. Good morning, Mr. Sykes. How are you?
Hey, good morning, Henry. Great to be back here. You know, I don't think I told you before, but my mother attended ECU.
Oh, is that right?
Yeah, she sure did. She had her first 2 years here of medical training. And so.
Oh, she's a doc?
No, she went on to be a nurse practitioner. Yeah. And so, okay. But she started here. That was quite a while ago, obviously. Yeah. But we got some good roots here.
Well, my daughter and my wife both are ECU nurses, the best nurses in the world.
Yeah, they are.
So that's great stuff. All right, let's talk about your race. How's it going?
Oh, it's going fantastic. You know, momentum is an important part of this process. And so, I don't know if you saw our endorsements released on Monday. The former police chief and sheriff of Durham, both Democrats, endorsed our campaign. So
no
law
kidding.
Enforcement Democrats have come.
how'd you get that done?
Well, I think even they realize we're in a crazy time now. Yeah. We need to be there to support our law enforcement. And so they've came up and gave us a thumbs up, and we're really happy about that.
You know, that's really interesting because I think there is a movement from Democrats to Republican because of these riots and all the things that we're seeing. I mean, people are people of color are tired of the craziness. I mean, there's a group of people that you know want to support the Black Lives Matter movement, and of course, I'm like Mark Robinson. There's a small BLM and a big BLM. I support the small BLM because I think that Black lives do matter, of course. And just like, you know, why would you say that a black life doesn't matter? It's absurd.
The philosophy is true, but the organization is Marxist.
Yeah, the organization is a Marxist communist organization, and they're trying to change the very culture that we grew up
in
this
great country. They want to destroy the family. They want to take apart what this country is made for, the very fundamentals. As you read through we just encourage you to go to their website, read what they say about themselves, and then make your choice. But so, black lives do matter.
So absolutely they matter. And it's crazy that you even have to say that. Of course, everybody's life matters and black lives matter. But the new poll that just came out from ECU, you know, if I'm really analyzing it, I'm seeing a real strong move for Republicans in the state of North Carolina. I don't know if you heard the numbers, but Trump now up 2 points. He's been down as many as 4. That would be a 6-point swing in North Carolina for Trump. The Tillis race has become dead even.
Right.
Tillis and Cunningham now tied at 44. Less than a month ago, Tillis was down 4 points. Dan Forrest has gained 4 points on the governor. He still has some work to do because he's down 10. And then we see Mark Robinson's numbers. He's up 3 points. He's doing better than anybody else.
Right.
And so, you know, that's got to make you feel like there might be some momentum for
Republicans. We do. We see it shifting. I mean, people often ask us, how do you think Dan's doing? How do you think Trump's doing? And, you know, the polls are polls. They're hard to get right. So my poll is we drive across North Carolina, we look at yard signs, we look at barns, we look at flotillas, we look at flags. And I can tell you, they all seem to be on one side. People are energized about the president. They understand. And when you get this crazy buildings burning on television and people saying that there's a peaceful protest out there, people are just not that dumb.
Yeah.
And so they're figuring it out, right? One side is for protecting them and for helping them. And you got another side that's got a radical agenda.
You are in a race with a longtime Democrat incumbent, Elaine Marshall, who's been Secretary of State a long time.
Yeah.
So how do you unseat somebody like that? I mean, we see what Dan Forrest is going through, having to do that. I mean, you've got a longtime Democrat with some name recognition in North Carolina, certainly not like the governor. So how do you take her out?
Yeah, and you're right. I mean, she's been there. She was in that office before Cooper was our attorney general. And so she's been there a real long time. But, you know, surprisingly, her name recognition is not that strong. So the polling that we've done indicates she really hasn't done a good job of getting her name out. Somebody who's been in office that long should dominate the polls. That's not the case. And so we have a large open playing field is there. And she's never had to compete against somebody who's been successful in business. And so we bring that to this office, and so we've got her in a difficult spot. You know, and as a political outsider, what I'm lacking is a political network. And so, you know, we've been working to expand our network, and that network helps you raise money. And so it's hard to outraise an incumbent, particularly one that's been there for 24 years. But, you know, we have outraised her every reporting period that's been filed. People want a Christian businessman in the office that drives economic growth. So it's going well.
Let's talk about your background. You've been on before, but people may not remember. Again, if you're just joining us, this is E.C. Sykes, who is the Republican candidate, won the Republican nomination in the primary, and now will face Elaine Marshall, the Secretary of State, for the Secretary of State's job. Give us your background. You say successful Christian. I know that is what you hang your hat on in terms of the way you want people to see you, but give us the proof of that.
Sure. So, I mean, it is my record is what we've accomplished, not a political record, but a record of life. First nine generations of our family in North Carolina were farmers. I'm the first one that wasn't raised on a farm. And I'm an engineer, and so for those NC State fans out there, you know, they got a friend here, met my wife there as well. Education has served me well. We got a chance to eventually move from the engineering side into the management side. I was CEO of one of the fastest 50 growing companies here in North Carolina for 2 years, and so was able to create tens of thousands of jobs over our career. My last role was a CEO of a public company. I've been a CEO of a LED lighting company as well. So three CEO roles, and on the executive team of a Fortune 500. That was a $28 billion company. Our General Assembly budget is $24 billion. And I was responsible for 35,000 people
in 20 countries. Well, Cooper wants it to be $25
billion. Yeah, he's pushing, isn't it? He is pushing. So it's a real broad business background there. Never have run for office before, but it's that faith piece that brought in. Look, what we see happening to our values and the attacks that's going on for what North Carolinians stand for has got to be stopped. And so we're standing up to give to our kids and grandkids and other people's kids and grandkids the same opportunities that were given to me. And so we worked our way through college and had the chance for success. We want them to have the same opportunity to have success and prosper.
E.C. Sykes, candidate for Secretary of State. I would venture to guess, and you probably have learned this in your journey here, that most people don't even know what the Secretary of State does in the state of North Carolina. When you hear Secretary of State at the federal level, you know that that is the person that's doing our negotiations with all the different countries in Europe and having to deal with all the international issues. That's what the Secretary of State does at the federal level. But nobody knows what the Secretary of State does at the state level, so tell us.
Yeah, and that's another example that we've got a person who hasn't been very effective in that role. It should be impacting people's lives. Really, the way to think about it is economic growth. Some people call it the front porch of economic growth for North Carolina. So if you're going to come here and start a business, if you're here and starting a business, you're going to do it by registering at the Secretary of State's office. If there's any regulation activities that occur, they're done through the Secretary of State's office. Counterfeit goods, trademarking, many other things. But the important piece is we don't have an economic vision here of what North Carolina is going to be in the future. That brand, who we are, should be generated through the Secretary of State's office. So we're here to help drive employment opportunities, economic growth for the people in North Carolina.
E.C. Sykes, candidate for Secretary of State, live with us here this morning. I've told you this before. You have a lot of assets, but your best one might be Susan, your wife.
Oh, man, she's a bride. She is. She's my gem. Yeah. We normally travel the state together, so sorry she's not here with us this morning. She's taking a campaign day off. We're running pretty hard these days. Last night, we're down in the High Point area, had a great event down there with Mark Robinson that was there and some others. And so a great joy to go across the state with my bride.
If elected, what's your plan to help economic growth? What are you going to do?
Yeah, so the first thing we need to do is shrink our regulations, right? And so regulations have grown to the point that they're interfering with companies that want to create jobs and want to be able to drive. And so we've got to get smaller. I've heard it said that, the larger government gets, the smaller the people get. And so let's pull that back to a sensible level to allow that to growth. And we need to drive back to the rule of law. We have an issue here in North Carolina that the incumbent has commissioned hundreds of illegal aliens as notary publics. And so that's got to be fixed, right? We've got to get back to where we're
why notary publics? What's the strategy there?
Well, yeah, and so what does a notary public do, right? So if you sign a legal document, they're the ones that's trusted to identify who you are in that process.
And but so, isn't it a criminal act to notarize something? It's certainly at least a misdemeanor, right? To notarize something illegally.
It is, right? And that's an issue that people ought to pay more attention to. I mean, there's been a house that sold in Charlotte, for instance, that to the wrong person. And so somebody came in, they weren't there, and literally stole their house in that case. But one of the things that is interestingly brought up to me recently is the prosecution rate for those seem to be abnormally low. And so we've got an issue. I think it's important, just like we fund and support the police, we got an issue where the rule of law hasn't been followed. We need to go back to that area. And again, I got Elaine Marshall, who stood up and led the march for Occupy Raleigh during that protest, an anti-capitalist movement, and she was a leader there. And her question was, what took you so long to get here? And so we just need a business person there to be able to stand for businesses. So the first thing we need to do there is get us back to rule of law, make it easier to do business in North Carolina, and then to bring down the cost of doing business here.
Sounds like some of the stuff we heard from Roy Cooper during the NCAE rallies. Let me guess, you have not been endorsed by the NCAE.
No, I have not been endorsed by them. No, I haven't. But there's plenty of others we were proud to have the endorsement of.
I want to ask you about another question. I don't know what role the Secretary of State would play, but we're seeing a real effort to unionize in North Carolina. The nurses, they're about to vote over in Asheville. Nurses are going to vote about whether they want to unionize over at Mission Hospital. Mm-hmm. The big corporation has come in, bought the county hospital, and now things are different. Nurses don't like the conditions. They say that some of them are promoting this narrative that it's not safe because of COVID and those kind of things. And I don't know whether that's true or not. A lot of people think that it's the union narrative to try to gain votes. But, we're a right-to-work state. North Carolina has always, it's not that we don't have unions, because we certainly do have some people who are unionized, but, it's a right-to-work state, and generally organizing a union in North Carolina has been more difficult. So where do you stand on that?
Yeah, and generally, it's in the best interest of the people not to go down that path. I believe in it. There's a time and place in our history for those unions, and that time and place is past. If you looked at the unions now, they seem to be more interested in taking care of themselves than they are in taking care of the people that are paying them their dues. And so for mm-hmm. that reason, in general, union activity has been decreased. They're not serving their constituents the way they should serve it. And that's normally the case here. And so I'm not as familiar with that particular. I've heard some pieces mm-hmm. of that particular unionization activity, but not familiar with it that I want to particularly speak to it. But in general, North Carolina is a right-to-work state. I think it's in the best interest in of the people to continue down that path. And so, you know, now, you know, again, my competitor has taken some PAC money from some unions, and so she may have a different view of that side.
But what are the chances?
Yeah, yeah. But we like to work right-to-work.
Well, I'll tell you, if they get a foothold in North Carolina, it's going to spread like COVID.
Yeah. So. Yeah. You know, for a lot of reasons, we're an attractive state. People are continue to trying to attack us to change sure. our culture
yeah.
that's here. And that's really what's pushed me to run. I mean, we need to stand up. We don't want to be confrontational. We're not angry, but that's not going to work.
Yeah. EC Sykes, good to see you.
Thank you so much. Check out our website, ecfornc.com. More information there.
Catchy. ecfornc.com.
It's easy.
E.C. Sykes for running for Secretary of State. Good to see you, my friend.
Thank you so much.
All right, we got to get a break in. We're coming back with a Pirate Report next.
Top Dog Academy is Eastern North Carolina's complete dog training facility. Top Dog provides an excellent environment for dogs of all ages with training services and workweek daycare. Top Dog is located on Highway 43 South, just 4 miles from Bells Fork, and features a comfortable, healthy environment and a spacious facility for daycare and a brand new, beautiful facility for training. Call 752-8215 or visit topdogonline.com.
Come on out Highway 43 South to Top Dog Academy, where we know dogs.
My name is Dr. Neeti Armistead, Chief Medical Officer for Vidant Health. The following simple steps will help keep you and your community safe. Stay home as much as possible, wear a mask when out in public, avoid large gatherings, practice social distancing, and wash hands often. It's also important not to delay needed care. Vidant has taken important steps to provide you and your family with a safe environment. Learn more about COVID-19 and Vidant's response. Call 252-847-8000 or visit vidanthealth.com/COVID-19.
Mom, I'm so bored.
The most music for your workday with Mark, and Laura, Beth McCall, and Dylan McKay.
The most music for your workday plays here.
That she was up for adoption, she was dead set on, no, I need to just be realistic about my life and what my future holds.
That's when she came to me and she said, would you be interested in us adopting you? I didn't think that I would have a family again. I didn't think that I would go to college. I didn't think that I would have love. And with that, I just feel like my world is just so much brighter.
Sexy and I know it.
It must be time to get back to Talk of the Town with Henry Hill.
It might be crap, but we love it.
On Talk 96.3 and 103.7.
Okay, welcome back. Good to have E.C. Sykes in the studio this morning. Tomorrow morning, Eric Trump, who's going to be in North Carolina, is going to be on the show. He's going to be on the phone. Not going to get him in the studio.
Huntersville.
He's going to be out near Lake Norman. Did you put on a tie?
I did.
You must have a big meeting this morning. Or did you do that for me? Trying to match my new glasses, aren't you?
Did it for Mr. E.C. Sykes.
Let's do our Pirate Report. Pirate Report brought to you by our friend Ashley Nicole Russell at anrlaw.com. She can show you a better way to divorce. She doesn't want you to divorce, but if you're in the middle of a divorce, you need to contact Ashley Nicole Russell at anrlaw.com. Offices in Greenville, Beaufort. Greenville, Beaufort, and Raleigh. ANR Law, one of our Pirate Report sponsors this year. Here's McGee. What's happening, McGee?
All right, East Carolina returned to practice Tuesday afternoon. The session lasted about an hour and a half and was the Pirates' first practice since August 19th. After practice, head coach Mike Houston shared his thoughts on Governor Cooper's announcement on North Carolina moving into Phase 2.5.
We've got to look at what that means for us for practice. We've got to look at what that means for us. You know, does that mean we can meet a little bit easier now? What does it mean for our stadium? On game day, we've just got to see what the interpretation is, you know, through our local officials and see how that how we can adjust after that.
And also in other sports on Tuesday, President Trump is pushing for the Big Ten Conference to resume fall sports amid the coronavirus pandemic. He spoke with reporters and said that Big Ten Commissioner Kevin Warren, that he and Kevin Warren are pushing very hard to have football go on in the Big Ten. Ian?
You think it's going to happen?
No. I don't in the fall. I think it's going to be a January start for them or springtime start for them.
I don't know. They're talking about trying to start in mid-November.
I think it's a long shot. I hope so. I hope they can make it happen, but it just seems like a long shot.
What's going to be the difference between November and January?
I don't know.
Again, forget flatten the curve. We're now wait for the vaccine before we can do anything.
Yeah.
And yet we now find out less than 10,000 deaths nationwide just from COVID.
Yeah.
Even from the CDC's own numbers, which, by the way, Cooper didn't even mention that yesterday.
I know.
Didn't even mention that yesterday. All right, we are done this morning. Don't forget, Friday morning, we're going to be live at Krispy Kreme, and Brandon Snead, the author of the new book, Sooner, the Lincoln Riley book, Making of a Football Coach, is going to be there signing books. You can come down and buy one, and he'll autograph it for you for Labor Day. And tomorrow morning, Eric Trump live on the show. So stay with us. Have a great Wednesday, everybody.
The trade-in deals are hot at Greenville Toyota. We're cutting checks on the spot for trades and giving you up to 130% of book value. That means if it's worth 10 grand, we'll give you 13. Rush to Greenville Toyota.
Top Dog Academy provides training services and daycare for dog owners in and around Greenville. The Top Dog facility, located on Highway 43 South, just 4 miles from Bellsport, is a comfortable, healthy environment where dog owners can feel secure about leaving their pets. Top Dog Academy teaches people how to have a better relationship with their dog. Call 752-8215 or visit topdogonline.com.
Come on out Highway 43 South to Top Dog Academy, where we know dogs.
My name is Dr. Neeti Armistead, Chief Medical Officer for Vidant Health. The following simple steps will help keep you and your community safe. Stay home as much as possible, wear a mask when out in public, avoid large gatherings, practice social distancing, and wash hands often. It's also important not to delay needed care. Vidant has taken important steps to provide you and your family with a safe environment. Learn more about COVID-19 and Vidant's response. Call 252-847-8000 or visit vidanthealth.com/COVID-19.
Freshwater wetlands cover only 1% of the Earth's surface, but provide habitat for 12% of all animals. Why are wetlands such good homes? The plants, water, and soils of wetlands provide food and homes for mammals, birds, fish, and more. Sadly, wetlands are at risk, and that puts wildlife at risk too. To find out more about wetlands and how you can help, visit ducks.org.
While consumer use of electronics continues to grow, the environmental footprint continues to shrink thanks to lighter, less material-intensive, and more energy-efficient products. The Consumer Technology Association and its members want to help minimize environmental impacts by making recycling old tech devices as easy as buying new ones. Your old TV, smartphone, or computer can give new life to new products. Go to greenergadgets.org, put in your zip code, and find convenient drop-off locations. Live green, buy green, and recycle responsibly at greenergadgets.org.
The deals are hot now at Greenville Toyota. Hot, hot. Get a 2020 Corolla now under 17 grand. Plus, get no charge lifetime maintenance included with every purchase. That's the Greenville advantage. Greenville Toyota, where our volume saves you money.